It's Candy from the Candy Show here with a segment of Candy Reads. I am reviewing a very interesting book today. This is The Opposite of Loneliness, Essays and Stories by Marina Keegan. Introduction by Anne Fadiman. What drew me to this book was the story behind the book. That is the author right there in that picture, in that pretty yellow coat, Marina Keegan. She was a very ambitious young student who was accepted into Yale, started writing in high school, wrote all the way through Yale. In fact, in the last publication of the Yale newspaper before she graduated, she wrote this great piece called The Opposite of Loneliness. She graduated cum laude from Yale, was to have a play produced in the New York Fringe Festival that following summer. And in addition to that, she had scored a job as an intern at the New Yorker. So, you know, New Yorker magazine, when you're a writer, is like, it's all that. So everything was as wonderful as it could be. 20 years old, the world by the tail, when 5 days after graduation, her and her boyfriend traveling home from, I think, his parents' place to go to her parents' place, had a car accident, and she died. So after her death, her professor and her parents, and her professor is Anne Fadiman, gathered together what they thought were the best collection of her writings and put them together into this book. The very first thing, the introduction is wonderful by her professor. You know, kind of the professor gives her thoughts on the kind of young woman that Marina was. Then the next piece you read is the piece that was in the Yale newspaper called The Opposite of Loneliness. Sorry, they're mowing the lawn. There's nothing we can do about it. And that piece is really, really good, The Opposite of Loneliness. And then it is short stories and essays, and they're not all, you know, Pulitzer Prize winning, but I think when you understand that this young woman died at 20, and these were collected writings from her life up to that point, I mean, hello, most of us don't even start writing until we're well into our 20s or 30s, so when you consider the age, I think it's an incredible tribute to her. I think it's amazing that she was able to have something published posthumously. Who knows what kind of great writing would have come out of her in the years to come. The other thing I found interesting about it is, you know, I'm an idealist, I'm a feminist, I'm an activist, and I'm 45, so my perspective has changed now, right? It's although I'm very in touch with who I was at 17, 18, 19, 20, I'm not that anymore. I'm 45. So what I found really interesting about it was reading the perspective of an idealist, an activist, with a 20-year-old voice. And sometimes I think as feminists, that's one of the mistakes that we make is the older we get, because that's part of life. The older you get, the wiser you do get, and that is true. But sometimes we make a mistake with that in that we discount the voices of younger women. And to do that is to discount the experience of being a 20-something woman, which I think being a young woman is one of the most exciting things in the world. And it's the time that you're allowed to make mistakes, and it's when you're finding out who you are and all of that. So because I came of age in the 80s, it was very interesting for me to read the writing of someone who, you know, came of age after the turn of the century. So I really highly recommend this book. It's just an amazing story. Again, I'm not telling you that all the stories and essays in here are fabulous. They aren't all, but a couple of them are really, really good and worth the read. And I think just the overall story, just I wanted to buy it just to pay tribute to her, because what happened to her sucks so bad. And I figured the least I can do is read some of her stuff after she's gone. The Opposite of Loneliness, Essays and Stories by Marina Keegan. Candy gives it thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up if you're enjoying the book reviews. Make sure you're following me on Goodreads, where you will also see my opinion on this book. And I will catch you in the next video. Until then, Please don't drink and drive, and wear a condom every time. See ya.